The Philippine Health Department says the country remains at moderate risk for COVID-19 despite declining infections. Health Undersecretary Maria Rosario Vergere says the country's two-week growth rate decreased to a negative 21%. But she says the country's health system capacity remains at high risk with ICU utilization rate at 73%. Vergere adds Metro Manila is among the regions that show a downward trend in COVID-19 cases, but it is still classified under moderate risk for the disease.
The health department flags a decline in COVID testing output in the past week across 14 regions. The agency says the largest decrease was reported in Metro Manila. From over 266,000 RT-PCR tests in the National Capital Region, declined by 14% or 37,000 tests. The DOH says the agency is now looking into the cause of the decline. But officials leading the country's pandemic response are unfazed.
Ang ating positivity rate ay bumaba na ng napakalaki mula sa pinakamataas nito na halos 30% nung mga gitna ng September. Ngayon, nasa 20% na lang. Ang ibig sabihin nito, yung dami ng mga nagpo-positibo sa mga tinetest natin ay 10% na ang binaba. At nakikita na rin natin ito sa pagbaba ng ating mga positive cases every day.
The Philippines ready for its COVID-19 vaccine rollout for minors in Metro Manila. It will be conducted in 6 hospitals, including the Philippine General Hospital, the Philippines Children's Medical Center, and Pasig City Children's Hospital. Authorities say the phased pediatric vaccination will prioritize 15 to 17-year-olds with comorbidities, followed by 12 to 14-year-olds. COVID-19 vaccinations for minors will start on October 15th.
Dahil sila po ay mga minor, ay kinakailangan po talaga ng parental consent. Ano? Hindi po pwedeng sila-sila na lamang magdidesisyon. Ito po ay ilulunsad sa mga atin mga ospital muna. Para lang sa ganun, kung magkaroon man ng mga adverse event following immunization, ay at least nasa loob na po ng ospital at mabilis na matugunan kung magkaroon man ng emergency.
The Philippines receives 1.8 million more doses of Pfizer's COVID vaccine Sunday. The shots were donated by the U.S. through the vaccine sharing platform COVAX. The latest delivery brings the country's vaccine supply to over 77,410,000. Vaccine Chief Carlito Galvez Jr. says a portion of the Pfizer jabs would be allotted for minors.
Presidential spokesperson Harry Roque is speaking out against vaccine inequality. He claims world donations to the vaccine-sharing platform COVAX were done out of the guilty conscience of rich countries. Roque says the countries that donate jabs to COVAX had secured about 80% of the global vaccine supply.
Ang COVAX voluntary. Feel good na mga mayayamang bansa dahil minonopolize nila ang supply ng vaccine. At dahil nga kinakailangang i-address naman ng guilty conscience, mamigay tayo ng konti sa ibang mga mahihirap na bansa. Hindi po yan ang solusyon sa pandemya. Dahil sinasabi po ng WHO na no one is safe until all of us is safe.
Overseas, New Zealand is abandoning its strategy of eliminating the virus amid a persistent Delta variant outbreak. Prime Minister Jacinda Ardern said the government will instead focus on living with the virus, controlling its spread and ramping up vaccinations. 29 new cases were recorded Monday, taking the total number in the current outbreak to 1,357. Majority of the cases are in its largest city, Auckland, which has been in lockdown for nearly 50 days. Ardern says lockdowns will end once 90% of the eligible population has been vaccinated. About 2 million citizens, or about 48%, are fully vaccinated.
With this outbreak and with Delta, the return to zero is incredibly difficult. And our restrictions alone are not enough to achieve it quickly. In fact, for this outbreak, it's clear that long periods of heavy restrictions has not got us to zero cases. But that is okay. Elimination was important because we didn't have vaccines. Now we do. So we can begin to change the way we do things. We have more options, and there's good cause for us to feel optimistic about the future. But we cannot rush.